Hello friends and welcome to my YouTube channel, Way to Success. In my previous video, we have had a proper discussion about the introduction of your cancer, right? We have discussed what is a cancer, what is tumor, what is the difference between the two, the type of tumors, what are the major causes which lead to the cancer, and the properties of cancer cells. Right? In today's video, I'm going to explain you various mechanisms which are leading to the cancer. Right? So, we are going to start with the proto-oncogenes. We have discussed later that what a proto-oncogen is. It is a normal gene, right? It is a normal gene which if undergoes mutation, it will gain a gain of function will take place. And what will happen? It will ultimately lead to the generation of cancer cells, right? So it is a kind of normal gene which when altered by mutation becomes oncogenes that can contribute to the cancer. Here are certain examples of your proto-oncogenes. RAS proto-oncogenes are there, like your HRAS, KRAS and NRAS. MYC proto-oncogenes are there, CMYC and NMYC. FOS, JUN, ABL, these all are the kinds of your proto-oncogenes, right? If any kind of mutations occur in these proto-oncogenes, it will ultimately lead to the cancer, right? So basically the gain of function will take place in these cases. What is the gain of function means? The increased expression, right? The increased expression or the activity of these proto-oncogenes will ultimately lead to the generation of cancer. So, gain of function, that is your increased expression level or activity of the proto-oncogenes result in the conversion of them into oncogenes. What are oncogenes? These are the cancer-causing genes, right? Moving on to the mechanism associated with these proto-oncogenes activation, we have discussed that there are various mechanisms, right? This one is related to proto-oncogenes, but methods are there or mechanisms are there which are related to your tumor suppressor genes or cell division mechanism. There are a lot of mechanisms there. So we are going to start with the proto-oncogenes one, and what will happen in this, the proto-oncogenes will ultimately activate or overexpressed and will lead to the generation of cancer. So first of all, the first mechanism which is associated with proto-oncogen activation is your chromosomal translocation, right? Now what is translocation? First of all, you should know the general terms related to the particular mechanism so that it will be easier for you to understand the mechanism behind it. Right? So, what is translocation? Translocation occurs when a segment from one chromosome is detached and reattached to different non-homologous chromosome. We already know that chromosomes are present in homologous nature, right? But what happens in translocation? In translocation, segment of one gene or one chromosome, a segment of one chromosome, that is a particular gene or different genes, will be cut or detached from that particular chromosome and it will be transferred or translocated, we can say, to the another chromosome. But this chromosome is not homologous, it is non-homologous in nature, right? Two different chromosomes. So this is what the translocation seems like. This is one chromosome and this one is the another chromosome. This one is the breakpoint. Breakpoint is what? Where your chromosome is breaking down so that it can detach from its fragment, right? This particular segment will be detached through its breakpoint and will be translocated to another chromosome, which is non-homologous in nature, right? Now, what is the purpose of this translocation? This translocation may result in activation or overexpression of the proto-oncogenes. So basically what we are saying that this translocation will ultimately lead to the overexpression or gain of function of your proto-oncogenes, leading them to become cancerous, right? Or oncogenes. So moving on, there are certain examples of the cancer which are generally induced by the chromosomal translocation. So we are going to discuss two type of your cancers, right, which are generally related to your translocation. First one is your Burkitt's lymphoma and chronic myelogenous your leukemia, right? So in Burkitt's lymphoma, what happens? It is a kind of translocation which occurs between two chromosomes. And what are these chromosomes? The chromosome number 8 and chromosome number 14, right? So translocation is taking place between these two chromosomes. The c-myc gene which is present in chromosome 8 will be detached from this chromosome and will be rearranged or transferred to the chromosome 14, right, leading to the condition which we call Burkitt's lymphoma. What happens in your chronic myelogenous leukemia? In this, the translocation occurs between chromosome number 9 and chromosome number 22, right? The translocation of the CABL, which is present in chromosome number 9, and then it is translocated to chromosome number 22, right? So first of all, we are going to discuss about the Burkitt's lymphoma. In Burkitt's lymphoma, what is this? Burkitt's lymphoma, it is a type of lymphoma. Lymphoma, we have discussed that basically your lymphomas are generated from the immune cells, right? The region of their generation is immune system or immune cells basically. So what happens in this? It is a type of lymphoma in which cancer starts in the immune cells that are called the B cells. These Burkitt lymphoma are specifically generated from the B cells, right? That is, B cell transforms into the cancer cells, right? It is associated with impaired immunity. Obviously, if it is working on the immune system, it is hindering the immune cells, it is overexpressing these immune cells, B cells, ultimately it will affect the immunity of a person, right? So it will lead to the impaired immunity or impaired immune system. Basically, it is common in young children. You will see most of the time you will get these kind of lymphomas in the childhood age, right? So there could be two mechanisms by which translocation leads to cancer development, right? In both of these examples, we will see two different kind of mechanisms. First mechanism we are going to see in the Burkitt's lymphoma, that is your transcriptional deregulation. And in chronic myelogenous leukemia, you are going to discover another mechanism, that is the protein structure alteration. Now, what are these mechanisms? In transcriptional deregulation, what happens? The translocation affects the regulation of adjacent genes, resulting in structurally normal proteins but expressed in inappropriate level. So what is happening in this transcriptional deregulation? The term is expressing itself. Deregulation means the regulation is being hindered, right? So what happens in this? Whenever the translocation takes place, what happens? The gene which is translocated from one chromosome to the another chromosome, it will affect the alternating genes, the genes which are means present nearby to that particular gene, and it will lead to the deregulation or change in regulation of those adjacent genes, resulting in the structurally normal proteins. The normal proteins will be generated, but the inappropriate level will be expressed, right? They are maybe higher or lower in their levels. So their that function will be impaired, but they are normal in structure, right? So basically what is happening? One gene which is getting translocated to another chromosome, the adjacent gene will be hindered or it will be deregulated, right? Now what happens in the protein structure alteration? Obviously, the protein structure is being altered, right? So what happens? The translocation alters the coding sequence of the nucleic acid, right? The coding sequence is being altered, right? Creating structurally altered protein products. They are structurally different, and obviously they are structurally different, so they behave abnormally, right? These are the two major mechanisms which are leading to the cancer, right? By the process of translocation. So in Burkitt lymphoma, you will be seeing that there will be transcriptional deregulation, right? And in chronic myelogenous leukemia, we will be studying the protein structure alteration mechanism. So in this, you can see that Burkitt's lymphoma is a model for transcriptional deregulation, right? So what happens in this kind of carcinomas or lymphomas, what happens? There are three chromosomal translocation can occur. Three different kind of translocation can take place. We have already seen that in Burkitt's lymphoma, the translocation is taking place between the chromosome number 8 and chromosome number 14, right? But with chromosome number 14, it can also have the translocation process with the chromosome 2 and chromosome number 22, right? So c-MYC proto-oncogenes found on the chromosome number 8, it can translocate with the immunoglobulin loci of chromosome number 2, chromosome number 14, or chromosome number 22, right? So it has three major translocation sites on different chromosomes, right? It can choose any of them and can translocate and lead to different kinds of lymphomas. Especially when it translocates to the chromosome number 14, you will get to know about the Burkitt's lymphoma, right? So what happens? We will see with the help of a diagram. You can see there are two normal chromosomes, right? This is chromosome number 8 and chromosome number 14. They have different breakpoints. This one is your c-MYC gene, right, which is present on chromosome number 8, right? And here you can see the enhancer elements. These are the enhancer elements of the immunoglobulin heavy chains, right? So here immunoglobulins are working as the enhancers. These genes contain the enhancer elements. Right? What are these enhancer elements? If you have recalled from your replication, transcription and translation, you will get to know that what are the enhancers. Basically, what are the enhancers? These are the short regions of the DNA that generally bounds to the activator. And after it binds to the activator, what will happen? It will enhance the transcription. Right? So various transcription factors will bind to these enhancer elements and will help in the activation of the transcription. Right? So what happens when the c-MYC gene will be transferred or translocated from chromosome number 8 to chromosome number 14? Right? You can see here the translocation has occurred. So what happens? This c-MYC gene is nearby to these enhancer elements, right? The immunoglobulin genes, the heavy chains of your immunoglobulin, right? These are adjacent to your c-MYC genes, right? Here the c-MYC gene is working as the transcription factor. So what happens? The c-MYC gene, which is present on chromosome number 8, will be translocated on the chromosome number 14. Right, near the heavy chains of immunoglobulin. These, your chromosome number 14, which has immunoglobulin genes, they have enhancer elements, right? They are present in much more amount in these chromosomes, right? In chromosome number 14. So what happens? The C make act as the transcription factor, and it is regulated by these enhancer genes, which are the immunoglobulin genes, and the deregulation of these will occur, leading to continuous expression of the genes, right? Because of this continuous expression, it will ultimately lead to the formation of your cancer, right? Because these genes are basically working in the cell division or cell development, proliferation, right? So what happens if they remain in the open condition or continuously they are expressed, they will lead to the cancer, right? So we have discussed what are the basic proto-oncogenes are there and what are the major mechanisms which are related to the translocation mechanism of your cancer, right? We have discussed about the Burkitt lymphoma and how it is means what are the factors which are leading to this kind of cancer, right? In my next video, I'm going to explain you the second kind of your cancer, that is chronic myelogenous leukemia, and in that what mechanism is taking place, the protein structure alteration, right? We will discuss it in my next video. So till then, stay focused on your study and keep reminding yourself that this time you should have to pay full attention towards your study and work hard, right? So till then, stay tuned and stay focused. If my videos are somehow helping you in your studies, please give me a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe my channel and share these videos with your friends. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.